This is Tales of Heroes number 78 for July 1st, 2011. Enough with the cats! Welcome one, welcome all, welcome to another exciting episode of Tales of Heroes. We are almost live from the year 1944, and we've got a great show for you today. Tell a few tens of friends, won't you? I am Bridger, and joining me as always is my untethered co-host, Rogers. Welcome to the show.
Well, I'm glad you untethered me, Bridger. We've got a great team game for you guys today for episode 78. We got some great old pros coming in, so it should be a great game. Looking forward to it.
All right, starting off with our guess the map situation here. Have you figured it out yet? What if I pan around this way? If you haven't figured it out yet, you probably never will. Let's take a look at it. It is, in fact, Lorraine, ladies and gentlemen. Lorraine, good old favorite, had some changes in the balance patch that, for the better, I think, making it another very interesting game to play. So, let us jump right into the introductions. Armor Reborn and Newbine playing on the American side here versus 2PE on the German side. That is Kale Ray and Predator Hun. So, let us jump right into it. Let's get going at the 5-second mark. All right, starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, unpause. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see how this one starts out. Now, I should point out this is a replay that is not available anywhere else. Arma Reborn actually specifically saved this and didn't post it to GR so that we could use it here. So if you have a replay that you want to submit to us to try and get casted here on Tales of Heroes, I would recommend doing what he did and not post it online. We much prefer to use original replays that people haven't seen. Otherwise, you know, they get disappointed. Oh, I saw this already. So going to try to avoid that in the future. And hopefully we're going to do a 1v1 after this. This one was just, it just seems like it's going to be too good to ignore this week. And then the next one will be a 1v1, I can guarantee you. We'll make sure that happens. So if you've got any really good 1v1s that end in a close finale or just have some amazing, crazy stuff happening in them, or, you know, if you're just saying, yeah, it was a close game, but I want to know how to get better, I'm not that good, we can do some user-submitted stuff coming up soon. All right, so what do we got going on here? Panzer Grenadiers popping out everywhere.
Yeah, we got two PG start from both sides. One's building the logistic company is coming out from Kirei. I'd also like to point out that I believe that this map, this is going back. This is a real old school throwback, but this was the first 2v2 to be released in the original Company Heroes beta, if I remember correctly.
Are you sure? And I thought it was McGekin's War. I could be wrong.
I think it was both, wasn't it?
Maybe it was both. Yeah.
I think it was.
I know I played plenty of Hill 331.
yeah, that was a nightmare. Nice job here with both the rifle squads moving as one.
Yes,
to push off
definitely.
These PGs. But it looks like they're both going to mass up here again as well. Very interesting to see a logistic company out. That is a very ignored building for the PE, in my opinion, for better or for worse.
This is a large map, though. There's a lot of room that, especially in the north, it takes a long time for the PE to get up there. So scout cars wouldn't be that terrible.
That's true. Good retreat there in the middle.
Yeah,
very
they
good
had
retreat.
To. They didn't
only
lose.
Lost one man.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was a good retreat there. I like that.
They might also go for a vampire. That would be very interesting. If they
I have
could park
seen that
it like way
effect.
Over on the in the graveyard area at the plus 10, actually south of the graveyard area there, that could drop the allied income by a lot.
By half, doesn't it? By half, I think.
Half
so.
Of everything after the first. Okay. Anyway, let's see what's going on here.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that in a second.
Yeah.
Riflemen are flanked by these Gewehr 43 guys in the back.
Yeah, there's so much American infantry here, though. He's doing such a good job of the teams working together here. Whereas the PE one Predator Hun, he's just beginning to come back on the field, but it looks like they're massing now for a big push. Do you know if any of the Americans are upgrading with flames yet, or do we not have the munitions for that yet?
Let me look and see if I can. I can't see any engineers right now. Oh, here we go. We've got the scout car in the middle.
Nice. He needs to move use that scout car to move the units out of cover. Just get in there and start micering around. Yeah,
yeah,
that's very useful. Very useful.
It's probably not worth charging the rifles unless they're in heavy cover, I don't think. Though.
Yeah, yeah, it's true. But every little movement, it slows down their rate of fire, especially if they're dancing around an armored car constantly. They're not going to actually shoot.
True.
So
Oh, wow, look at this mass of green over here.
Incendiary grenades by that broken down glider. Very nice there. Forcing out of cover. So, Panzer Hun, or Predator Grenadier, went with incendiary grenades first. That's very interesting to see that. And now he's getting defensive off.
All right, let's see if we can fix this here. We're going to pause this in 3, 2, 1, pause. And we're back. Okay, so now we've got player colors up. Thanks. I can't remember who gave us a suggestion for that, but that's a very good good idea. So now we should be able to see the difference between the two sides.
We're losing ground. Very early incendiary grenades. That's so nice to see. And he definitely has the munitions to spend on it. So we're going to see that used to great effect.
In this map of buildings, incendiary grenades are necessary.
Oh, yeah, and even with all the cover, it's so useful to force an enemy out of cover because it does dot damage, if I'm not mistaken, and that will just force him off the territory for a little while.
Yep, absolutely. He's got this scout car. That's upgraded with the...
resource thing?
Resource, secured resources. OP. That's actually the British one. I don't remember what the hell it's called. But, yeah, it's the OP ability of the scout car there.
Yeah, I don't think he hasn't deployed it yet, and that's the only time when the bonuses pop up for defensive, I believe.
Yep, so that's an interesting. Now, I mean, the map is very big, but there's a lot of plus fives.
There are. So those could become a plus eight in no time, which would be very nice.
Yeah, it's just that the low munitions and low fuels, there's no medium or high fuels in this map either. It's a very low fuel map, which makes it very interesting.
Very infantry and munitions based, which is awesome.
Grenades.
We have a conf group company up here from Hun.
Oh, jeez.
Just coming out with an infantry after. Right now.
Nice grenade dodge there. By the
did they hop out of the building, though? Nice.
They were really tearing that rifle squad up. So early grenades for the Americans as well. At least one of the Americans. The other one's probably going to wind up teching up.
To bars or to motor pool or both.
I would think motor pool. There's no way you can go for a fast Sherman on this map. There's just not enough fuel. You have to go for an M8. But there's some maps where you can actually go for like a fast Sherman if you have two teammates and one of them is taken out and one staying with bars and grenades and such. Predators got surrounded here.
Yeah,
double
those
flamers
are flames
coming behind
down.
Him.
Look at
he
that.
Might lose it. There he goes. Just gonna make it out.
He was very fortunate there.
Double flames in the
nice
building.
Flame grenade into the engineers with flames.
Ooh.
Look at that. Burning. Having a house party and someone dropped the candles.
Apparently.
Oh my god. Look at all this infantry dancing around here in the middle. Both sides just running around like crazy. Good retreat there.
Interesting. I'm not sure what that grenade was supposed to hit. It looked like it was landing on his own guys.
Yeah, there were some Americans there, and I guess he was trying to predict where they were going to run, but it just didn't work out too well, unfortunately.
Infantry half-track, great counter for the flame engineers. They don't really do any
damage to them. We have an armored car up right now. Are you seeing that in the middle? Wow.
Really?
That's great
there
to see.
It is.
Yeah.
It
looks like there's a second one coming out from Panzer Jaeger Command right now. That's going to be devastating.
So he went logistic and then Panzer Jaeger. Interesting.
Yep. And we have a mortar half-track coming out from the comp grouper right now from Hun.
Yeah, so they're doing a good job of dividing the different companies, or not company, but buildings, so that they can get all of the different advantages that the PE get early in the game. They can get the mortar, but they can also get the scout car, but they can also get the armored car.
So they have the full range of versatility that the PE are known for, which is very smart to do. You can't get bogged down in one thing. I like, one thing I'm kind of interested to see is none of the VPs are capped for the Germans. There's only one point capped in the north for the Americans, but it seems like the Germans have been ignoring it. I don't know if that's for better
or... They had it at the very beginning. The engineers went and capped it.
Yeah. Another scout car out. Another armored car out. Pardon me.
I'm not sure what he's achieving by having these riflemen sit here, but it might just be distracting his opponent so he can't go and do anything else.
Yeah, look at that. They're coming down from the five fuel. Look at that.
Wow.
Okay.
Three squads. So Armor Reborn has four total rifleman squads. His income is now down to 248 manpower.
It's still that high. That's crazy. So who are you watching from, Arma or Nubine?
I'm watching from Arma's point of view.
Okay, and did he go grenades or was that Nubine?
I believe it was Arma earlier,
Okay. Oh my god, we have an infantry squad almost down. He's just running up that ramp right now.
Look at that. Yeah, one sliver of health. Looks like Nubine has bars now.
Oh, we have a rifle squad that went down by the five
fuel. Yeah. Mortar and the armored car got him, it looks like.
Mm-hmm. That was
I think that was Newbines. Grenade from Arma. Wow, that guy did a nice launch off the grenade. It's not as easy as the demo man makes it look. Yes, I've been playing Team Fortress 2. Okay, anyway. I mean, now that I haven't played it before, I don't want you to think I'm one of those new free players.
Those people.
Those people. I just got back into it recently. Anyway, so that's a nice division of labor, but the bars means that neither of them is going to get a really fast M8, which is almost what they need here against all this armored cars and half-tracks.
They really, really do need that. They need something to start taking on. I wonder if one of them might go Rangers. I just see that one of them built a WSC. Newbine has a machine gun team coming out
now. There
you go.
That'll also help. If they can get a couple of machine gun teams with some armor piercing, that'll force them off.
We have a few Shreks out on the field from Hun right now, and he's building the Panzer support command right now, so we might be seeing Panzer 4s.
Anticipating an M8, maybe?
It could be. He definitely was, because he went the Shrek upgrade as soon as he got the the mortar half track came out. He got the Shrek upgrade, and he called in a tank buster squad specifically, and then he upgraded two squads with Shrek. So he's definitely was waiting for those the M8 or whatever might be coming out.
We hold the initiative
from the American players there.
Taking Berlin by Christmas.
We have double capping going on in this plus 10. It's not going to make it go any faster there.
Yeah, right. Enemy unit down. It looks like Newbine just upgraded something at the barracks. I'm not sure if it was grenades or sticky bombs.
All right, and we're seeing what you like to see, Bridger.
There we go.
Yeah, we got
armor piercing. Yep. Sticky bomb it was.
Look at that sticky.
And it's gone.
Nice.
Boom. I think that Shrek's inside. Took some damage.
And before it killed the scout car, it's actually set up on the scout car wreck right now, Bridger.
Oh, wow. Nice. I thought it looked like a scout car. I wasn't sure if that was one pre-built into the map. It didn't seem likely. Here comes the machine gun pushing forward. Very nice counter. Low fuel counter as well. He's able to use the fuel for the stickies to help him.
Look at that squad. They're going in that building. That could be their death sentence right there.
Geez, yeah. Armored car is hammering him.
We do have an M8 out, actually, from Arma Reborn.
Yeah, from Arma, because I think he only got the grenades. Uh-oh, squad this in the front is done.
Oh my god, these guys are the Lost Battalion. Look at this.
He's chasing them both. Here he goes.
This could be a big mistake.
Oh, right into the M8. Oh no. Abort mission. Abort mission. No, he's just driving around. Nice. He's still going for it.
Enemy machine gun.
Oh. Two machine guns there.
That was a defensive vet as well. That's why it lasted as long as it did. And we have Martyrs out as well from Cures.
I think he saw the M8 and the machine gun here, and he thought he was going to go around it, and he went right into another machine gun.
Yeah, I didn't see that one going. No one expects the second MG.
That machine gun's going to get out of the building. He might lose it. Oh, he did. He did lose it from some MP44s. Shrek's on one, MP44's on the other. Again, very, very good coordination between both of these teams. Both players taking the correct upgrades to make sure that they have all the versatility that they need.
I agree. One thing that I would like to see the American players do is head south. It is uncontested right now except for that OP scout car. And if they diverted the Panzer Elite attention from the north, which they've all been able to concentrate all their firepower in the middle and north, to chop up the Americans as they come into the meat grinder, I really think they need to branch out and go south to split the forces if they can.
Right now, PE's got a pretty decent fuel advantage, having that plus 5 right there.
Mm-hmm. And Predator has gone for Scorched Earth booby traps, so he's scorching points right now in the south.
With Panzer Grenadiers or with...
He was doing it with his little kitty cat because he didn't have anything else at the moment. Giant push here in the north. Look at that. MP44s are in trouble.
Those riflemen, do they have any vet rifles yet?
This graveyard is going to be their grave if they don't get out of there.
Ooh, M8's going to chase them in reverse.
He's got an AT half track, though. You see that guy? He's just at the bottom.
Wow, that's interesting. So he's got the Panzer support command then.
Oh, my God. Yeah, he didn't see that second armored car.
Nice. There it is.
Nice.
But geez, he's got to get out of there. He doesn't have anything to support the tread break.
Look at that. Locusts. Freaking locusts everywhere. Nice AP or HE explosive shell on the M8 that's immobilized right now. It's cooking rifles.
Oh, no. Oh, no. What is that? Infantry? Right on the martyr. And the retreating Panzer Grenz.
Yikes.
And the immobilized armored car.
Oh, this is a big turnaround here. Wow. All the Panzer Elite are retreating right now. And the locusts are fanning out and they're going to the right-hand side of the map.
Yeah, must be Nubine got, let me see, infantry company? Yeah, there he is. He's got infantry company with the...
We have a traffic jam right now, right outside of the Panzer Elite base.
Yeah, the Mr. martyr and the mortar.
Stop, yeah. He didn't have his emergency lights on, so the martyr got a little mad.
Martyr's trying to turn around. It's trying to turn.
I'm actually surprised that enemy didn't put a shot out on that. You see advanced repairs here, which he is upgrading just now. Nice. Like to see that. I don't think we have any vet.
Oh, I went and screwed everything up by changing to a different person. Oh, well. Can't see the Germans on the mini-map anymore.
Sticky bombs. Oh, no.
Or at least not on the command map, I mean. Mm-hmm. I gotta stop doing
that. We do have Americans pushing south right now, which is nice. I don't think they're gonna be able to deal with this armored car, though. If they had bars, they would be able to, but he might have a sticky here. Yeah, he does.
He does. Very nice. It's not gonna do quite enough, though. Damaged engine. It's not moving!
Those defensive bonuses on the OP are quite good, but yeah. The armored cars are pouring down now, as well as Panzer Elite to respond with their armored cars.
Oh, the Ketton's doing its repairs here.
So we have tank hunters, and Scorched Earth. Interesting. Oh my god, these armored cars are in deep trouble here.
A double M8 chasing them. Uh-oh.
If you would have chased him, you might have been able to get one of them. The AT Aftrack's moving to respond, though. He's got two of them. No, just one.
Oh, Ketton's down. I think he was probably worried about running into those Shrek squads.
Our war machine.
Yeah, he should be afraid of that. That's rather frightening.
Ooh, got a vet on the... and he put down a mine right there. See that?
Oh, yeah, I do. He's spinning around.
The other one's putting down another mine. Oh, he's getting out of it. Oh, boy. Shrek's in the infantry half track with an AT.
Doing
the
drive-by. Look at that.
Yep. They're going to get him.
Oh. Enemy unit.
There it is. Nice.
Good night.
Very nice.
Now it's just so much scrap.
It is scrap.
So the Americans still holding the north and center VPs. They still got a pretty commanding lead right now.
Really do.
And by commanding, I mean they're up by 30.
They've secured the middle VP. They did a really good job of taking the middle back from the Germans. That was a perfect coordinated assault. They had the Locust Army run in, then they dropped artillery on that stronghold that the PE had. Very nice.
Where's the shots coming?
They found this mortar after.
I haven't seen any vet rifle squads at all anywhere. Mm-hmm. They haven't been doing a whole lot of killing. I think that's just a testament to the Panzer Elite doing a good job of keeping their units alive and retreating at all the right times.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what's going on back over here? Still, there's no vet over here. Oh, he's building a howitzer, though. Look at that. And we've got armor company for the Americans, for the other Americans. So we've got armor and infantry. And he's got a howitzer built in his base right now.
I really hope Kilray keeps laying these teller mines everywhere, because they're going to make short work of armored cars. I'm pretty sure it kills them in one hit.
The M8, you mean?
Yeah. Any armored car, actually, I believe it does. It'll kill any armored
car. Here comes the artillery. Enemy unit.
He might have wanted to hold off on that barrage there, so it would be a little bit more of a surprise. Now the PE know and no discourse to them.
Well, they knew he had infantry company, but dang, look at all these rifles.
I don't think they would have expected the howitzer so soon, though, in all honesty.
Maybe not. And then straight down the right-hand side.
That's a good idea.
So here comes the push.
You've They're carefully pushing up. I like to see how they have all these support units in the back to see if anything tries to counter and flank.
Losing ground.
Yeah, the martyr's in a decent spot. Mm-hmm. It's just got this stupid building in the way, really. Oh, these poor grenadiers just trying to decap the fuel. That's all they're trying to do. Look at this map.
Get
it's
them
completely
out of there.
Changed. A while ago, the Americans were pushed all the way back into their base.
The AT Aftrack's in deep.
Oh no, damaged engine. It's toast. It's got nowhere to go. Just drive off that cliff, buddy. Just drive off the cliff.
Enemy unit.
They had a better chance if they drived off the cliff.
There was a hedge in the way, so in his defense.
Yeah. Like mechanized. Something suppressed all the Americans. What was that?
It was a mortar round.
Oh, it was a mortar. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, mortar round from the half-track.
Oh! Martyr just got hit by a direct shot from the howitzer.
Artillery. It could get it here.
Oh, it could. God, it's trying to get out. Look, it's got a damaged engine. It's just spinning in place. It's gone into premature disco mode. Now it just turned around. It's like, oh, okay. Maybe if we... Oh, geez, destroyed engine now.
I don't even want to say that.
Now it's trying to finally drive away very, very slowly.
It barely looks like the treads are even moving. We have an attack. The PE are moving into the middle with only two squads. I don't know how well this is going to go.
Oh!
He's trying to take up AT gun.
Nice, AT grenade. There goes the AT, the anti-tank gun. Nice Shrek movement. Killed all of it in just one big... Now they're going to cap it.
Our front lines are collapsing.
We have artillery on middle. Nice. Good retreat. There goes 150 wasted.
They probably could have walked out, but I guess it wasn't worth wasting, taking the chance there.
Our fuel point is being taken by...
See, we just
here
have
comes rifle spam. Here it comes.
Yep, locust hordes are on their way.
That,
yeah, we do have one.
Affectionate rifle spam. Interesting, we've got a medic station here, too. I didn't notice that earlier.
That's really going to help them recoup their losses. And since they have been taking quite a few losses on both sides, that'll be very helpful in tipping the manpower battle against the PE.
Another sneaky AT gun placement up here. Watching the flank.
Nice artillery again hitting those armored cars.
Is he getting real? What did he have line of sight to that? No, he probably just the bare maximum range of the
territory sector.
Yeah, or the AT gun. Does he have two?
One of our points.
He does have two howitzers.
That is.
That martyr got repaired. It's still alive. It's good to go.
He might want to think about when he gets that Panzer IV up, and he's upgrading it now. He might want to think about sending the Panzer IV in to kill both those artillery pieces.
Yeah, that might work. You could just, you know, engage the fast movement. Nice retreat there.
Yeah, big battle in the north here.
Martyr is just worthless. He built a second one, just waiting for tanks. Oh, a grenade.
Nice flanks from the south. Look at that.
Enemy unit.
Another grenade. AT gun. He's trying to kill it. He can't kill that AT gun fast enough. Finally got it. Counter grenade from the Americans killed a squad and vetted them up.
Vet two, look at that. Man, we're seeing grenades being thrown around like candy.
Yeah, decent amount of munitions on this map. Sticky bomb on the Panzer IV.
Reinforcements are ready for the field.
And he didn't have skirts, so that's why it damaged the engine there. Wow, complete takeover in the south. Check this out. We got
Nubine has gone all down there.
Oh, he just did.
Like, he's using the infantry to lay mines with their defensive operations.
That is amazing. I love seeing that. That's such an underused ability, and it's way too useful.
It's so much fun to use, too.
It is.
And look at this AT gun trying to get it back to base.
Stands at 300 points.
Oh, an American sniper. Nubine pulled out a sniper from the WSC.
That will definitely help. I wouldn't be surprised if they go four-man squads, at least one of the... Oh, no. Kilray already has gone four-man squads.
Yep.
Very nice. Artillery is firing again. It is hitting middle. And a Calliope is out.
Too. Oh. Ooh, that squad. One guy left. Go, man, go!
Enemy unit.
He didn't retreat it. Lost it. That Calliope just got a lot of kills. Five kills.
If it'll be held for war crimes, but he might be. Treason.
Middle is still in Axis hands, but they completely lost the south. Fight going on in the south here. Armored car. Oh no, they ran into a mine from the defensive operations. Up. Abort mission. Abort.
That was brutal. Yeah, there's so much stuff. All the Americans are doing a great job of projecting their strength right now.
Yeah, at this point.
Giving EP a hell of a time.
They've got a pretty commanding lead.
They do, and they're almost about to walk into their own artillery there by that five munitions or the fuel point.
Uh-oh. I heard it. It was a trap. Yeah. Boom. There you go. There's your booby traps. A nice little trick if you like playing with booby traps is to put a mine opposite of where you place the booby trap, because the thing to do is when you activate a booby trap, immediately run straight past the point, because the booby trap is going to activate on the side that you're attacking from. And so if you put a mine on the other side, the mine will stop them, and then they'll get hit by the booby trap too. Panther 4 was, I think, the right call right now. They did a lot of kills on the AT guns.
Yeah, they did a pretty good job. He does need skirts on him, though, I think.
Yeah.
It's kind of interesting he went with the upgraded machine gun on top as opposed to the skirts.
Well, he's facing all infantry.
Yeah. We have an M18 tank destroyer. Heelys out.
Hellcat.
He needs to deploy that Panzer IV in the south. That's the only way it's going to survive this. Deploy it so it fires faster.
Yeah, he got it far enough away. I think he's okay.
Look at those 44s.
Nice. 44s.
Oh my god! The M18 hit a mine. It hit a teller mine and was instantly destroyed.
Wow. Look at that.
That was awesome.
One-shotted. There's still some dead guys in the top. Oh, that's hideous.
And they're burning.
And they're burning. It's terrible. I'm glad that Company of Heroes doesn't have a smell-o-vision. Calliope at the south. Oh man, that is terrifying to behold from ground level. And the howitzer might finish this squad off. He's running! He's running! Get the hell out of there!
Enemy unit down.
I'm surprised they're gonna persuade this guy to come back. He just watched all of his buddies die, running away as he drops around all over them.
Yeah, they've got to have some kind of advanced brainwash mechanism back at HQ to just make sure that they don't remember anything.
All they have to do is say, for the Führer.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, of course, for the Führer. Anything for the Führer.
It's a programmed word.
Yes, indeed.
In the north, we have a little bit of capping going on. Only one squad, but some armor and half-track there backing them up. It's kind of nice to see.
They've had this... Newbine's had this machine gun in this building for an awful long time, and he backed it up by a couple of snipers.
Those snipers are definitely a pain. Tank busters up against bars.
That's not going to end well for the Panzers.
I wonder if he's saving up for... Panther battle group right now. He's floating close to Manpower.
Versus bars. He did not activate the ability.
And a martyr is coming up. Sector in middle. It didn't.
And there were a booby trap right there too.
Yeah, they're all just
the real booby trap, not the stupid little Ketten one. That one went off like 3 or 4 times.
And if Newbine doesn't notice this sector in the middle has been artillery marked, then he is in for a surprise.
He changed his mind.
Lame sauce.
Can you see that yellow tint on the minimap if you're playing the opponent?
You can.
Okay, I thought so.
It's unfortunate.
So,
pretty expensive ability.
The Germans pulling themselves back into this one. I thought the Americans had it, especially when they pulled out those machine guns and everything, but the Panzer IV has completely changed, and they lost a number of AT guns.
They did.
Panzer IV is actually chasing these snipers. Got him in one hit! Nice pick! Oh, that's a big manpower loss in one shot.
But he's caught on this building, and he's moving extra slow.
Oh no!
Deploy him, deploy him! Stickies and an
another
AT
one
gun.
For another AT gun. Whoa. Immobilized. Oh boy, he's done. Oh, that one needed to kill it in order to win. Jeez, you're right about the ejection seat, man. They keep flying out this top of it like he's sitting literally on top of the gas tank.
Yep. One of these days, Wehrmacht's R&D will share the secrets that they've learned from their mistakes with the Panzer Elite.
Oh man, it could have a three-way cap here for the Panzer Elite.
Whoa. Yeah, they're taking north, middle, and south, especially. Artillery hitting south.
Calliope.
Armored operations.
Get that Panzer IV out of there, man. Don't leave it there sitting there.
The Americans just got armored operations. They have a tank depot or anything yet over here? Yeah. He hasn't built anything out of it yet, though, as far as I can tell. Two Calliopes, but no Sherman. Sherman could certainly battle it out with the Panzer IV.
It could.
The only thing he has to worry about is tank busters, really. He should be able to provide bars with that.
Oh, he's got something else to worry about now. Two Panthers out in the field.
Oh, there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Panthers to the rescue.
Yeah, the German zoo in Berlin has authorized the use of Panthers.
Yes, indeed.
We're down to 300.
He's about to discover the Panther threat.
I think he's just going to sticky it. Yeah, okay. Threat? What threat?
Yeah, it doesn't only have a two versus infantry. But, I mean, I'm just trying to think. 1,000 manpower.
I think he could have spent that better on, I don't know, a little bit of everything, to be honest.
I mean, he could charge the base with these guys and take out the howitzers and probably get the calliopes, too, if he's fast. But he already lost one
enemy unit
damaged engine.
Our artillery's coming out on Panther Causeway. One Panther is almost down. Oh, my dear God.
Uh-oh. Main gun destroyed. Oh, I missed him.
Passing to a critical. Lose.
Two more just barely missed.
Takes it out of there. I don't know what I'm going to... Oh!
Lost. There it is. Jeez, that's some expensive loss right there.
Did you see that shell, the one that was aimed for the original Panther, fire over and hit the other one on the engine? It's like a heat-seeking cruise missile. Just someone in New York sitting
wow.
in an office.
Enemy unit. Yeah.
Right, I guess.
Uh-oh. Wow, that was like a game of chicken right there, with both sides having their squads down to nothing, daring the other person to retreat first.
God, we're seeing some horrible pathing from units. Are you noticing that too?
Yeah, they got stuck on the tank. MP44s, devastating.
They're getting devastated right now by.
There's not a whole lot of veterancy on the Panzer Elite side either.
Yeah, it's been a very even game in terms of, like, retreating
and losing
around
squads.
The same time. Yeah. Been very even. Rangers in the north shooting it out. A Vet 1 Ranger squad, actually. Nice. But an armored car showed up to dissuade them.
Yeah. Properly kited. Your bazookas are nothing.
There's so much infantry at the American base. Look at it. It's like a rifleman convention.
It might be a whole company. No, I'm just kidding. It's a platoon.
Barely.
It's barely
heroes.
A platoon. Oh, don't charge with those MP44s.
Nice. He is getting him out
of
there.
Oh, he's got a grenade. Okay.
Why is he capping now? That's a...
I think he thought he was going to force him to retreat. Oh, geez. They are so dead. Keep them alive. Yes, Panzer IV to the rescue.
That thing is being amazing. My God. This is so awesome.
That American medic station's probably given him at least two squads or three squads by now, though.
I would definitely agree with you there. That thing has been versatile. It's all hell.
Both sides have bars. There's a Jackson again. Maybe we'll hit another teller mine.
Oh, that nice. Good hit from the martyr. Look at that. That thing already has to pull back. And the Panther does a shot. Nice penetrating hit. Martyr's getting hit by artillery, has to force back, and here comes the Locust.
The Panzer IV is the only thing that stands between American domination.
We have a secured sector under attack.
Artillery shells are just tracing the tanks.
Nice job keeping that Panzer IV out of the way.
Yeah, definitely.
They're
sniper
one of our
being charged by us. Now it's a single Panzer Grenadier. That one guy, he could have taken out the machine gun instead of retreated through the machine gun's path.
And died.
Oh, there you go. Machine gunner taken out by the Panther. Jackson, I think, got taken out by the Panther. Panther charge.
Now available. Trying to take territory.
Almost got that sniper there when he was cloaked. Sticky bombs are just so
hitting
brutal. Oh!
Standing still for too long. Oh, there's a mine there, too!
We're losing the fuel sector.
Now he's just chasing those... Damn you!
Damn you all to hell!
It needs veterancy. It needs offensive vet. That's what the Panther needs. It's got plenty of defenses. It needs the ability to accurately hit infantry.
Won't be helpful. So much low-health vehicles here in the middle. Many.
So again, Americans in big trouble now at 100 points left. They don't have any victory points right now, but they're charging north with another M18. And the only thing that's here to stop them is an infantry half-track and Panzer Grenadiers.
That low-health squad there, good lord. They are a vet one,
munitions
though.
Point under
vet
attack.
Nice.
Middle is getting carpet bombed.
Down to 100 points.
Goodbye, infantry half-track. Time to go away.
Oh my god, is he gonna make it? Weapon crew reporting casualties.
Barely.
Ah, the Hellcat's got an upgrade machine gun there. It actually does a little bit more damage against infantry.
Yeah, it's a plus three. That is pretty, it's pretty damn good, actually. Panzer IV is getting heat-seeked by 105. Its engine is burning.
Slowly driving out of the way, though. I think he'll be okay. Armored car, on the other hand, is driving into the action. I can take it. A booby trap is triggered. Where's that? Down in the south.
Nope, north.
Sorry, very nicely responded to.
Yeah, they've done a great job of keeping an eye on their squads and totally negating the booby trap ability.
Still good worth mic. Trying. Every once in a while, you catch him.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. At very least, it distracts him from the squad for a little bit, you know what I mean? I mean, from the point.
Mm-hmm.
Which is always good. Dude, the booby traps were awesome. Earlier.
Chasing the rifles.
Bet two. They don't know what they're doing, apparently.
Hmm. It's the armored car kind of just stopped shooting. Points. Oh, never mind. He told it to attack the machine gun.
That is weird.
To try and make sure they couldn't, they were going over as making as if they were going to reman the machine. He said no. Cloaked M18 Hellcat in the north.
Yeah, in ambush mode. That's nice.
Oh boy! Oh man! Oh boy! Flattened this whole area. He just keeps bombarding it.
The north has fallen. A lot of stuff coming in the middle right now. Calliope's looks like they're getting closer to make a more accurate barrage.
Enemy unit down.
Panther's waiting
thing.
For you.
This is one little useful tip also for the allies to keep in mind in team games. Any wrecks on the map, run over them with vehicles, because the only thing that can come of them that's good would be your enemy getting a little bit of experience from destroying them or from salvaging if they're the Wehrmacht. So always destroy them, you get a 1 or 2 XP, but it's better than
enemy
to go into your enemy.
Down.
Jeez, I don't know how this one's going to turn out. They're going to get artilleryed soon. That's got to be off cooldown pretty soon.
Yeah, he does have enough, but he...
Rifle
he is popping into south.
This is just Armor Reborn fighting in the middle. Against...
Panthers.
Uh-oh, booby trap in the south!
He's not moving, that's a Vet 2 squad! Oh, it was a Kettengrad booby trap, it only blew up once.
Yep, but he is gonna lose it regardless.
M18 went down in the north.
He's busy in the north. How is this guy not dead? There he goes. Damn, that was a big loss. Does he get an off-map combat group right there?
Yeah, he did. That's gonna help him hold the north, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah. I love getting mortars and machine guns together.
It is useful. One squad running up against three. Oh,
we got another
separate.
Panther battle group in here in the north.
Yep.
I'm still not sure that was the right call.
Yeah.
But the Americans at 32, they just needed something else that the Americans couldn't stop, really. Oh, but an AT gun could do.
Enemy unit down.
Those Panthers are just not worth it. It just seems like they're being countered way too easily in the north.
Yeah, well, only one of them so far. The other one, the whole point of going north was to stop them from decapping this point. You were 25
right.
points away. You lost every single point.
Oh
they
my
had
god,
all
I never noticed
three.
That.
They lost the middle, they lost the north, because they only have these Panthers. I think that was definitely a bad choice. He's trying to kill that AT gun.
Trying, and the AT gun is just sitting there.
Not even turning.
Charles and Phil have now ended their lives together. Panther went down.
He's
gotta be careful with that second one. If you just look at the TAC map right now, it's crazy. We just have a Hummel out right now. Hummel. out of the field from Scorcher. That's going to be brutal.
These sticky bombs are absolutely annihilating all this armor.
Yeah, they're totally crippling them. But look at this. Armored cars are coming in from the middle. And if they flank south, they can kill all this stuff. Armored car is also on the way to respawn from behind.
Enemy unit.
He lost the south and lost the middle, but he capped it. He capped it. Yep. He lost the squad, but he capped it. He's going to cap the south, too. That's going to put a lot of pressure on the Americans. Deployed the Panzer IV here against the AT gun. And the rifle squad might kill it. Yep, it's going down. That had a vehicle kill, too.
Did.
We're down to 20.
To kill one of the Panthers, if I'm not mistaken, which I probably am.
That Panther. It's getting hit by mortars. If the mortar killed it, that would be hilarious. Another rifle squad goes down to this Panzer IV. 23 kills on this Panzer IV.
Yeah, that thing is brutal. It's been alive since the beginning of the game, I think.
Yeah, he's done a good job, especially all the number of damage the engine has taken. Oh, no.
This could be the end of it, though. We have another off-map combat group racing in right now. This Panzer IV probably isn't going to survive the Hellcat here. No!
I don't think so. I don't think so. He's repairing it, but it's not going to do anything.
Helmut Schmidt and his crew have fallen.
Enemy there it is.
Poor guys.
He's desperately trying to take out the T-17. But that's okay. There's a Panther.
I don't know, man. T-17s are quite fast.
Yeah. Oh, he stopped it.
Blocked
it with the nice...
Block them with the armored cars. Oh! Oh, one of the armored cars killed the T-17, I like.
What happened to the Shrek squads? They all died, I think, at some point? He hasn't rebuilt them. That's, I think, why they keep getting the Panthers.
Hey, check this out. The M18 can't run over enemy units. Enemy infantry.
Seems,
casualties
yes.
being reported.
Enemy unit down. Look at this. The guy in the turret is trying to turn to shoot at the infantry, but the main turret keeps turning and he can't do it.
It's Vet 2 also. You seen that? Very nice. He's trying to run him over and it's just not working. That's hilarious.
The driver must be drunk. Yeah, now he's got Shreks on those guys. He upgraded them during the course of the battle. What's going on in the center here? Armored cars, one of them with 11 kills. Might stop the Americans from taking. No, they didn't. They didn't stop the point. Artillery coming in. Oh, man. This is hard fought.
Yeah, no kidding. This artillery has been very effective at area denial for the Americans. This has been crucial for them.
Why? He's sending out four squads with 3-2-2 guys all going north. He's got to. He's only got 9 victory points. He can't let them take that. But the Rangers do the job. All of that stuff that was fighting in the north, the only thing that's left was a Ranger squad and a Panzergren squad.
Yeah, that was definitely the last stand right there. That was insane.
Look at that machine gunner has zero health. Literally has zero health.
Taking casualties.
Don't worry about it. They have churches and they have band-aids in the church. So.
Yag Panther.
Oh, wow. And it's being chased. I love how it has to run away from riflemen. You like that? I love that. That's so great.
A Yag Panther and a Panther.
Both of them. And if there was a King Tiger, then they could all have a tea party while running away.
Yes.
A rifle squad. It'd be great.
Oh, man. Lots of reinforcements in the north. It's all of it almost dead. But
he just built a Ford HQ.
Yeah. Uh-huh. A Ford HQ, sorry. That'll certainly get him some solidification.
That should definitely help.
9-219, and the Americans start a comeback.
Nice.
They just have to hold on. If they lose, game over.
Yeah. This is definitely getting crazy because now the Germans have artillery support too, but they're really keeping in the back. I don't know about that.
We are losing a victory point.
He's got one target on the south and one target on the middle. Let's decap the middle. There we go.
One's firing on middle. Oh my god. It's hitting the Calliope's. Oh no! Wow, what a Calliope is dead. What the hell did that happen?
Casualties being reported.
That building in middle
finally went down. What did he have in there? Machine gun?
Yeah, I think so. They're definitely massing in the north, and this Panther could go down at mid.
Wow, how did he get this? Did he get line of sight back here? What the hell?
It's a valid question.
Kenton's capping in the middle. He's just trying to cap it. If I can cap this, we'll win. Oh my god. Oh no, the AT gun one-shots the Kenton. They've got,
that's just not fair. I mean,
they've got a bazooka.
K-Cat, what's it gonna do to you? Nothing.
Rifle's about to kill this Panther. Nope, destroyed engine. Never mind. There goes the bazooka they had. That was a Shrek, sorry, Panzer Shrek.
One guy just casually drops it as he dies. I love how the Panther is just staring at them. Do you see that? It's
yeah.
Just like, hey.
I know you're there, but I can't reach you. I have destroyed engine. Oh, jeez, Yak Panther got walking into more Calliope.
Bridger, I don't know if you saw that, but a Calliope actually killed the other Calliope that the Yak Panther was going
No!
On. Yeah. It's Vet 3 now. From killing another Calliope. Oh, man.
The enemy is after our victory point.
Apparently that Calliope was the commissar of the Calliope.
I guess so. That Yag Panther is just going one-on-one with an M18 and an AT gun, or one-on-two, I guess. That's
not
a good plan. Oh, this, the middle's being taken again.
It is.
Full health Gren squad.
Over as well. Houston, we have a Pershing on the field.
Well, now the Panther and the Yag Panther would be useful, but they're all but dead.
Pershing just casually turns and fires at the ground when it's looking at the Panther.
This Panther has every single piece of it destroyed.
Yeah.
And it then bounces off. It's like the 5% bug all over again.
We'll see if the turret can get damaged.
Still, he's like turned it around in anticipation of leaving. Has to keep slowing down. Finally got it. Wow, one kill gives the Pershing a vet.
It's because it was vet too, I believe. That's probably what it was.
Yeah, it was also a Panther kill.
Don't worry, we have two more on right now. God, two more Panthers.
Well, that would certainly be enough to deal with the Pershing, I would think.
Armored car needs to get out right now. It is staring down a Pershing. The Pershing doesn't feel like firing, though.
No, it's just out of his range.
He's just trying to intimidate it, like bouncing all over the battlefield. Starting to look more and more like Mars every day. Zero gravity and all.
Yeah, those MP44s are going to be really effective against that tank. It's a good thing they were all shooting it.
Yeah.
Yeah, he could lose this Pershing if he's not careful. Nice flanking with the Panther. Nice. Very nice, splitting up.
AT grenades, look, down to half. Wow.
Pershing's going to be safe. No, he turns on Allied.
Machine.
Ridiculous. Back your Panther. Back it up. Oh no, he's gonna get it right now.
It might be worth it to kill the thing just because it has vet, you know what I mean?
I guess.
But
they could have just come in and killed it as soon as the Allied War Machine was over. Oh, this Panther's gonna go down right now too. Seriously, why can't the Panther have some use against infantry? Why can't it be
enemy unit
kind of
down?
Instead,
I don't know. I think
every shot, and there's no splash damage at all.
It is fail in that sense, but the thing it is, and how you need to use them is you need to support them with either infantry or armored cars or something like that. They can't go in alone. They can't be effective against infantry and total murder against tanks. That would just be super OP.
I mean, it's basically a Firefly.
Yeah. I would agree with that. With less sight, but yes.
Yeah.
And I mean, keep in mind that the Panther League can get Panthers a lot easier. I mean, they do have to go through three lines of tech from three different buildings, and then upgrade the final little ability. Oh my god, this squad in the middle is gonna...
Enemy unit.
Yikes. They could not survive.
Is that a Hummel artillery?
Yes, it was.
Losing a victory point.
Yes, it was. Wait.
Hey, the Pershing killed another Panther and got another piece of vet.
Wow, yeah, no kidding. These guys are desperate to cap the BP. Look at this. He might lose another squad here, man.
Oh, he's like, they've only got six. Why can't we do this?
Enemy unit down.
Engaging
Oh no! That was a triple vet on the M18.
I saw that, and then he went into disco mode.
Yeah.
John Travolta was the tank driver there. Decided to do some dirty dancing. Died.
Uh-oh. Engineers got hit by some booby traps, and the flames exploded.
Look at all these PGs here. Wow, on the right. Goodness.
Yeah, if the Panzer Elite could just push north with everything they have, they'll win the game. There's just...
Hard to say, actually, Bridger. I don't know. I think there's so much artillery, they'll probably be on off cooldown by the time that they get up there. They'll just be torn to pieces. Like, look what's happening now with this 5.
Yeah. Make out.
The Americans have done a very good job staggering out their artillery use so they can always have a piece firing when they need it. Very good job there. Mr. Pershing is knocking on the Panzer Elite door, asking for some sugar, and he's about to get it.
Oh, here comes off map. He dropped it on the Martyr, which was already destroyed.
Oh, that was a Hummel.
Oh, sorry, Hummel?
Yeah.
They have the same kind of chassis.
Yeah, they have the same chassis, yeah. But...
Martyr laying in wait as this Pershing goes by. Bam! Right in the face.
Nice hit. But he popped fuel repairs, so it's all bouncing along
one.
The terrain.
Nice.
Dear God.
Now it's out of range. Oh dear God, it's out of range. Don't turn that way. You're turning the wrong way.
Oh, what's happening here?
Oh, he's going to get in the way of his own. Oh, he's going to blow himself up. What's going to happen? Oh, I can't take it.
Going to do it.
Oh, wow. Holy crap. Those guys got thrown 120 feet. Did you see that?
The moment with all of them waiting, the German tank jumping team takes the stand, and there they go. They're attempting something that have only been tried once before. A synchronized quintuple cartwheel. Here it is. They're on their second revolution. Perfect form. Notice. Perfectly synchronized. They are experts at this, practiced for years. Third revolution. Fourth revolution. And there they are, on the fifth revolution. There it is. They just need to nail the landing. Here it comes.
Oh,
oh dear.
Oh, they
These
need...
These Panthers are just getting murdered. Nice.
Stunned. Stunned by the Pershing.
Look at all these 44s. Wow. March of the Light Brigade here.
Yeah.
Calliope's. Whoa.
Calliope's going to hit their own guys a little bit here, maybe.
Yeah. They're. Oh my God. Just saw a man fly like 1,000 feet in the air.
Uh-oh. Pershing triple vet may go down. Chase it. Chase it, you mofo. Chase it. Don't let
yeah,
it get away.
Yeah, he really should. Or at least face your armor. Come on.
What are you doing? It's getting away. You don't. Oh.
There is an unsung truce between Pershings and Panthers, Bridger. Oh my God! We have another Panther that went down in the back to artillery.
Enemy has 100 points and counting down.
You had him! You had two Panthers! All you had to do was click over here!
Bridger, one of the 105s has 4 tank kills and 15
injuries. Wow. They've got it, like, zeroed in right there. Look at this. He's using crew repair vehicles again.
Enemy unit.
Well, how many munitions does he have?
A ton. He's got almost 300 again. 69. Do they have OPs? Yes, they have OPs on 1-2 munitions points. That's how they keep getting these crew repair vehicles. I don't think he spent any time repairing that Pershing with anything else. Come on. AT grenades. Do it. They're all right there. There you go. One more.
Oh, my God.
Jackson almost killed the
munitions point.
The Pershing there.
Yep. Saw that.
Half laid mine. Uh oh. Panzer Elite taking the middle, but they lost the south. They brought up everything.
Serious. Look, he built the booby trap, the scorched earth tank traps. It's so awesome.
Where?
Just above the southern VP. See? They're all along that road there.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
They're all concreted in.
Yeah, some nice decorations. They can put flower beds in front of it.
Booby trap in the south. He didn't hear it. Boom!
That squad could know.
Oh, nice. Mate! What? Yeah. He got out of there. Whew.
That one guy just turned and then he burst into flames.
Yeah, he did.
Charlie, get out of here! Boom!
The enemy is after our victory.
Kitty
point.
Cat coming down to say hello to the VP.
And he's gonna run right in some bars. Uh-oh. Bars hit another booby trap. Get out of the way.
Do you see this defensive Maginot line set up in the north, spanning from middle to north? You see that?
Yeah.
Like all these cloaked M18s, the AT guns, the mortars. Good lord.
They are ready for vehicles. Line.
Yeah, no kidding. Oh, this Hummel could be in trouble if it gets sighted
here. But the M18s have the machine gun upgrade. I mean, they're kind of okay against infantry, too.
Yeah, they're not bad. More effect we get some Panther than a Panther, I'd say.
Uh-oh, MP44 is disrupt that.
He's down to 25.
Gotta get him, gotta get him.
Losing ground out there.
Oh, man, off map right on the victory point. Get out of there.
He doesn't see it.
He doesn't see it. Oh, boy.
Wow, thanks. Thanks, 105 crew.
Jesus! Jesus!
Four men.
One.
Obliterated.
Four men. One artillery shell. And
all
their destiny
dead.
Together.
Yeah.
In a world where you can embrace 6-2, ladies and gentlemen, it's 6-2.
Oh my
god. The Americans
god,
have it. I didn't even notice. Holy moly.
The game is over.
That whole time, the Germans just had to take 1 point. All they had to do was take 1 point. I thought for sure they'd get it eventually. I didn't even notice they were losing.
I can't believe it.
Man.
That was so epic.
But I think there was just way too many.
Well, there's so much happening on all three fronts constantly. It was really hard to keep up.
The
I'll be
constant,
honest.
They called in the Panthers again.
Yeah.
They called them in again. That was completely the wrong thing to do.
I think it was about four Panther battle groups called in at least.
They needed Shreks and
Panzer IVs and
Panzer
IVs
and Martyrs.
And, yeah, definitely.
And they had plenty of MP44s. They also needed that, but ugh.
More unit variety would have really helped them because they just fell into Panther syndrome, and Panthers do not counter what the Americans were throwing at them, which was everything.
Yes.
Everything, the kitchen sink and the dog Sparky. I mean, everything was thrown. I mean,
yeah,
literally.
They had the Panzer Elite team had some very, very good coordination at the beginning.
Yeah.
With choosing, you know, what buildings to build and helping each other out. But you're right, they fell into Panther syndrome. I think at least the red player did. Who's the red player over here?
Yeah, Hun. Hun really likes Panthers, apparently.
Yeah.
I like them too, but I mean, after the first... when the second battle group got annihilated in like a minute, I would have been like, okay, I'm going to build about 100 mortar half-tracks.
So... he really needed to, I think, like you said, I think, wow, charge those howitzers earlier on.
One if he would have done that with the Panzer IV early on, his first Panzer IV, he might have been able to knock both of them out. He might have lost the Panzer IV,
that
but
been
I
an
think
even trade, I think.
Yeah.
They cost almost as much as a Panzer IV, don't they?
It's each 45 individual? Fuel, I believe, or it's either 45 or 75. 75 could be the 88, I don't remember. But it's quite expensive. 450 manpower, and I believe it's either 45 or 75 fuel for the howitzer. So.
All right, which rifle squad had the most kills here? Which one survived the longest? Actually, there's one Vet 2 squad. I don't see any Vet 3 squads. There's
I
one.
Think you got killed. There was one that went down in the south. There was one that went down in the middle.
New
over
Bean
the course of the game.
Still up with 12 kills.
Yeah. There's one in the middle, too, another from Arma. It has 10. So, I mean, this was a brutal battle. Let's not mistake it here, folks. This was...
hard
there
fought.
Was so much
very
carnage.
Nice job done by the Americans, actually, though, in the north with the machine gun emplacement. That's the perfect time to do that, when they knew they had to hold it. They could then kind of ignore the north, you know, except keep an AT gun up there. They had plenty of Hellcats. They could have rushed up there with Hellcats if they needed to stop something from taking out the machine gun emplacement.
Yeah, I agree.
But Shreks would have helped them everywhere. They just could never get those Calliopes. The Panthers are too slow.
The artillery just murdered them. That's what it came down to. I mean, there were so many 105s hitting everywhere, and there were so many Calliopes hitting everywhere. I mean, look, one of the 105s has 4 tank kills. I've never seen that before, ever.
And the artillery is the reason that this game breaks down in 3v3 and 4v4 if, you know, especially with Americans and British, because they have so much more access to artillery. The Americans have the Calliope that they can get, and they do get all the time. It's very good. And the British have their built-in artillery. They have the priest they can call in. The only one that the Panzer Elite get is they can get the Hummel, but only if they go a specific doctrine. So, I mean, it breaks down because it's so hard to get back there. They're not vulnerable enough. I'd almost say, you know what would really be interesting? Sure. I bet you could fix team games if you increased the cooldown on artillery based on the number of artillery pieces out on the field.
Yeah, you know, they were tweaking that for a while. They tweaked the cooldown, and they tweaked what else did they tweak? They increased the pop cap that it would cost to build them, and the build time as well. I know they did that for 105s, and I think
I just think that you need to do it based dynamically on the number of things on your side on the field.
Yeah,
otherwise
I agree.
It doesn't really work, because the balance is fine in 1v1. They're very expensive, and it's possible that, you know, you have to retreat at some point, and then you lose everything.
Yeah.
But in the 2v2, the maps are bigger. It's much harder to take out two people who are guarding Calliope than it is just take out one guy and force a retreat. So.
Yeah, I agree.
Anyway, enough of our rambling about why artillery sucks and broke the game. Anyway, let's close it up here, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching. A little note here, just so you know, we're probably not going to have anything for the 4th of July week. So that Monday, the week of the 4th of July, I am going to be on vacation, but moving. I'm going to be moving all my stuff from one apartment to another, so I am not going to be able to record or do a show or anything like that. So this is the last one until the week after July. We'll still try and get... I also can't guarantee that I'll have internet, actually, during that time. I don't know how long it's going to take for the stupid Cox guys to get there. All right. Well, for Rogers, I am Bridger, signing off at yet another excellent Tales of Heroes. Have a good night, everybody.